You know, they say time is money, but I do not believe in that. I believe that time is life, and you should live it. The great inventors in this world created their identities using time and not money. So I'm asking you today, are you really living your lives or you're just existing? Alhamdulillahi wa kafa wa salatu wa salamu ala ibadihi alladhina astafa. Inna alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fahuwa al-muhtadi wa man yudlil falan tajid lahu waliyan murshida. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluh. I greet you all with the best of greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. My name is Rahma Mustafa Goni, and I'm here today to talk to you about an interesting topic, which is my real identity, or rather my identity and I. So before I begin, I would like to ask you some questions. Number one, have you ever asked yourself who you are? I am asking you now, who are you? Number two, what is your purpose in this world? What are you doing here? What are you doing in this dunya? And number three, what is your future? Where are you going to? So, first of all, what is the meaning of identity? Identity, simply put, as defined in Oxford Dictionary, it says it is the fact of being what or who a person or a thing is. So now, let us look at the scientific history about human existence. We, the human beings, we belong to the group of species called the Homo sapiens. So now, about 70,000 years ago, this Homo sapiens now created an elaborate structures which is called cultures. Then subsequent development of these cultures formed what is called the history. So human beings have some peculiar structures and features unique to them, such as having extraordinarily large brains, which is averaging from like 1,200 to 1,400 cubic centimeters. So sometimes it is not the weight of the brain that counts. The neural counts in the cerebral cortex of humans gives them more intelligence. It is generally assumed that having large brains, use of tools, superior learning abilities, and also complex social structures give human beings huge advantages. So it is self-evident that these features and even more make the humankind the most powerful animal on earth. So on the flip side, let us look at the Islamic perspective of human existence. Nothing was existing. This world was not existing until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everyone and everything. He says in Surah Al-Insan, verse number 1, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. There surely came a time over man when he was a thing not worthy of mentioning. So nothing existed, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now created us. So these two positions helps us to answer the questions who we are as human beings. Then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now gave us an identity. What is this identity? The identity is Islam. Your identity now sums up to you being a Muslim, a believer. You operate under the powers of La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. You did not become a Muslim by chance or by mistake, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose you to become a Muslim. So, but even with that, we the Muslims, we have to seek knowledge in order to discover Allah, in order to discover Islam. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now says in Surah Al-Hujurat, verse 13, Ya ayyuha an-nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu, inna akramakum inda Allahi at'akum. O people, We have created you of a male, a female, different families, different tribes, in order for you to know each other. But know that the best from amongst you is that who is conscious of Allah. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Kullu mauludin yuladu ala al-fitra, fa'abawahu yuhawidanihi aw yunassiranihi aw yumajjisanihi." Every child is born upon fitra. Every child is a born Muslim. It is now his parents or guardians that turn him into a Christian, a Jew, or even a polytheist. So at this point, you would agree with me that our identity is taking shape. But we're not done yet. We have so many questions to answer. For your life to be worth living, you have to be productive. We have to be productive in this world before we reach our final destination. So it comes to the question, what is our real identity? We are given two identities, one by science and the other by Islam. We live within these two identities, each of them telling us who we are and what we are supposed to do. But the real thing is for us to seek knowledge in order to be useful Muslims. Let's say, for example, you as a Muslim, you acquire knowledge. For example, you studied medicine. What are you going to be called? You are going to be called a Muslim doctor, a Muslim teacher, a Muslim pilot. It means you have combined your identity from science and Islam. Because Allah mentions in so many places in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, the believers, those who believe. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ is any good deed. That means productivity. So this is the best combination for you to become a useful Muslim. But then, there is a general misconception, unfortunately, even the practicing Muslims fall into it. Do you know what they say? They normally say, you do not have to love this dunya. You should despise this dunya. And they use it as a sorry excuse for not being productive in this world. They use it that way. When you ask them questions like, why are we not advancing like the Western nations? Why are we lagging behind in so many fields? Their answer is, okay, let them have the dunya and we're going to have the akhirah. As if these two worlds are disconnected. No, they are not disconnected. And also, what you have to be careful about is the life of this world or the comfort of this world is distinguished from the world itself. Whenever Allah mentions the life of this world in the Quran, it comes negatively. Let me give you an example. In Surah Al-Fatir, verse number 5, Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌ فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغُرُورِ. O people, the promise of Allah is true. Do not be deceived by the present life. Do not be deceived by the comforts of this world. And when he mentions the world itself in the Quran, he does that in a positive way. Example of that is Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 201. Allah says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ أَحْسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And of people are those who pray, our Lord, give us the best of this world and the best of the hereafter, and save us from the torments of the hellfire. So that means there is nothing wrong in living in this dunya for the best of society and humanity. What Islam came to root out is the fact that we take the comfort of this world and give it so much value than seeking the pleasure of Allah, than seeking the pleasure of our Lord. So what if the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the pious predecessors now had the same misconception? Do you think Islam is going to reach its golden civilization? I doubt that. So that means this world is the farmland of the hereafter. We have to plant the seeds of good deeds in this world for the hope of rewards in this world and the hereafter. The two worlds are intrinsically connected. So we have two identities, one by science and one by Islam, but there is the trending identity where you're going to be said, okay, you have to look this way, you have to be slim, you have to be fair in complexion, you have to have six packs. This is a trending identity. Know that you have a purpose in this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. You are not a commodity that only fits onto a cover of a magazine. You are unique in your own skin. So I urge you all to use what comes in the Quran and Sunnah and lead your life today in order to be successful in your future. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to guide us to guard our real identity until our last breath. Fasubhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha al-azim li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaikum. They normally say,